आप सभी को मेरा नमस्कार। प्यारे बच्चों, मैं क्लास 7, 11 और 12th मैथ्स के लिए ऑनलाइन वीडियो क्लासेस, जब से ये लॉकडाउन चला है, मैंने दूर दराज जो बच्चे अपने स्कूलों से दूर हैं और सिर्फ ऑनलाइन शिक्षा के भरोसे अपनी स्टडी कर रहे हैं, उनके लिए और ख़ासकर अपनी क्लास में जो बच्चे मेरे पास पढ़ रहे हैं, उनके लिए मैं ऑनलाइन वीडियोस जो है तैयार कर रहा हूँ। मैं अपने स्कूल में क्लास 7, क्लास 11 और क्लास 12 के स्टूडेंट्स को पढ़ा रहा था, उन्हीं के मैंने वीडियोस जो हैं प्रिपेयर किए, लेकिन मुझे डिमांड हो रही है, बहुत सारे बच्चे चाह रहे हैं कि क्लास 9 के भी मैं वीडियोस बनाऊं। तो आज ये मेरा पहला वीडियो है कक्षा 9th के लिए। इसमें मैं कोशिश करूंगा कि आप तक वो सारे मटेरियल पहुंचाऊं, वो सारे इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस, हर एक एक्सरसाइज का हर एक क्वेश्चन तो मैं यहाँ सॉल्व नहीं करूँगा, लेकिन वर्कशीट्स की फॉर्म में हर लेसन को मैं आपके सामने रखूँगा और इन वर्कशीट्स में सारे के सारे इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस होंगे, एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू से इम्पोर्टेंट होंगे और भविष्य में जब आप किसी परीक्षा में बैठेंगे तो आपके लिए ये मददगार सिद्ध होंगे। शिक्षा के ऊपर एक दो बातें मैं आपसे आपके सामने रखना चाहूँगा। यदि आपके अंदर किसी चीज़ का जुनून है, यदि आपके अंदर किसी चीज़ का जुनून है और आप कड़ी मेहनत करते हैं, यदि आपके अंदर किसी चीज़ का जुनून है और आप कड़ी मेहनत करते हैं तो मुझे लगता है आप सफल जरूर होंगे। तो प्यारे बच्चों, इसी के साथ साथ एक और दो लाइनें, जरूरी नहीं रोशनी चिरागों से हो, शिक्षा से भी घर रोशन होते हैं। तो कक्षा 9th के लिए जो मैं आज ये वीडियो आपके सामने पेश कर रहा हूँ, इसमें मैंने सारे इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस को इकट्ठा करने की कोशिश की है और वीडियो के लास्ट में मैं एक प्रैक्टिस पेपर भी आपके सामने रखूँगा। तो आपसे आशा रहेगी कि आप उस प्रैक्टिस पेपर को, हर क्वेश्चन को सॉल्व करेंगे और मुझ तक पहुँचाएँगे ताकि मैं देखूँ कि कितने बच्चे मुझे प्रैक्टिस पेपर्स को सॉल्व करके दिखा रहे हैं। तो आइए बढ़ते हैं आज के वीडियो के साथ।
वेलकम एवरीवन, वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस इम्पोर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस, यूनिट 1, नंबर सिस्टम। द नेम ऑफ द फर्स्ट चैप्टर इज रियल नंबर्स फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 9, सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स। द वेरी फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, क्लासीफाई 0.05918 एज रैशनल और इरैशनल नंबर एंड गिव जस्टिफिकेशन ऑफ योर आंसर। सो माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, हेयर वी सी दैट दिस डेसिमल नंबर इज रैशनल नंबर, इज ए रैशनल नंबर बिकॉज दिस इज टर्मिनेटिंग आफ्टर 8, द डिजिट्स आर टर्मिनेटेड, सो दिस नंबर इज रैशनल नंबर। This way we can give the justification, 0.05918 is a rational number as decimal expansion is terminating. Next question, classify 1.01001001 and so on as rational or irrational number and give justification of your answer. So what you say now? Of course this number is an irrational number. Why this is irrational number? 1.01001001 and so on is an irrational number because decimal expansion is non-terminating. Non-terminating mean dot 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 non-stop, non-recurring, digits are not repeating after decimal, non-recurring, okay, non-recurring mean not repeating, okay, Now our next question is question number 3. Classify square root of 9 upon 27 as rational or irrational number and give justification of your answer. So let us see what is this. So first of all, we have square root of 9 upon 27. What is the meaning of this? This is equal to square root of 3 into 3 divide 9 into 3. Right? So this means we can cancel. Here 3 is cancelled. So we are left with 3 upon 9. Again 3 ones are 3, 3 threes are 9. That means 1 upon square root of 3. So what we say about this? Numerator is a rational number and denominator is irrational number. So the quotient of rational and irrational number is called irrational. Ultimately, finally, the whole number, the given number is an irrational number. Question number 4. Classify square root of 12 upon 75 as rational or irrational number and give justification of your answer. So what is this now? Again, what we can say, square root of 12 upon 75, that can be written as equal to 3 into 4, 12. Here, dividing 75 by 3, 3 into 25. 3, 3 are cancelled, so we are left with 4 divide 25. Square root of 4 is 2, square root 25 is 5. So what we can say, this whole number can be written as in the form of P upon Q, where P and Q both belongs to integers and Q is not equal to 0. So this number is called rational. This number is called rational number. Next question. Question number 5. Find two rational numbers between minus 2 and 5. So first of all, a rational number between minus 2 and 5 can be written as a rational number between minus 2 and 5 is minus 2 plus 5 divide 2. That means 5 minus 2, 3 divide 2. Okay, so this way we can write one rational number between minus 2 and 5 is 3 upon 2. Right? So this is one rational number between minus 2 and 5. But we are required to find two rational numbers. So next is, a rational number between 3 by 2 and 5 is, same, 3 by 2 plus 5 divide 2. This means 3 plus, 2 is the LCM, 2 into 5, 10, divide this 2 into this 2, 4. That means 13 divide 4. So we can write now, finally we have the numbers. First number was minus 2. What was first number? This was minus 2. And in between minus 2 and last number was 5. In between minus 2 and 5, we got first number as 3 by 2, thereafter 13 by 4. So this way, this is the solution, that is two rational numbers between minus 2 and 5. Next question. Question number 6. Simplify 3125 divided 243 whole raised to power minus 4 upon 5. So exponent is negative. In order to make this exponent positive, we have to convert the given number into reciprocal form. So we can write this number as 243 divided 3125. So this number becomes now 4 upon 5 plus 4 upon 5. This way we have converted negative sign into positive sign. Now how we can write? We can say that this number can be written as 243 mean 3 raised to power 5. Okay? And 3125 mean 5 raised to power 5. So whole raised to power 4 upon 5. So what we can say? Further we can say this is equal to 3 upon 5. This 5 will go outside the bracket, whole raised to power. This is 4 upon 5. So 5 and 5 cancelled. We are left with 3 raised to power 4 divide 5 raised to power 4. So what is the final answer? Yes, this is 81 divide 625. So this is the simplified form of the given question. Our next question, question number 7. Express 0.6 bar in the form of P upon Q, that is rational number, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. So my dear students, let first of all we suppose the whole given number is equal to x. X is equal to 0.6 bar. So what is the meaning of this? This means x is equal to 0.66666 and so on. Suppose this number is number 1. Right? Now multiplying both sides by 10. Therefore we can write 10 into x. 10x. And here we also multiply with 10. So what becomes? This becomes 6 point. This becomes 6.66666 and so on. Right? So say this is number 2. Now we subtract. Subtracting. How to subtract? Second number minus first number. That means left hand side is 10x minus here left side is x. And right hand side becomes 6.666 and so on minus 0.66666 and so on. So this way 10x minus 1x becomes 9x. Right hand side after subtracting we have this whole will become 6. Right? So finally x is equal to 6 divide 9. Cancellation 2 into 3. So 3 into 3. That means 2 upon 3 is the required rational number. P is 2, Q is 3, 3 is not equal to 0. Next question is question number 8. Rationalize 1 upon 7 plus 5 square root 2. So how we can rationalize? First of all, writing the same number as it is, 1 upon 7 plus 5 into square root of 2 into changing the sign, plus becomes minus. So we write here 7 minus 5 into square root of 2 divide 7 minus 5 into square root 2. Right? Now multiplying. 1 into numerator, numerator are multiplied. So this becomes 7 minus 5 into square root of 2. In the denominator, we see that this is of the form a plus b into a minus b. The answer is, the identity says answer is a square minus b square. So here a mean 7 and b mean 5 into square root of 2. So accordingly, in answer, the whole square of 7, 7 square minus sign as it is, b is 5 into square root of 2, its whole square. Right? So we write the same thing here, 7 whole square minus 5 into square root of 2, its whole square. So we can write 7 minus 5 into square root of 2 divide 7 whole square mean 49 minus this 5 whole square mean 25 square root whole square mean 2. Right? So again we write this as 7 minus 5 square root of 2 divide 49 minus 50. That means 7 minus 5 square root of 2 divide minus 1. This minus will go in the numerator. So 7 positive becomes minus 7. Minus 5 square root 2 becomes plus because of the minus sign in the denominator. Plus 5 square root of 2. So this is the final answer, rationalized form of the given question. Question number 9, which is greater, 3 square root 3 or 4 square root 4? So here we write 3, third is 3, 3 is cube root of 3. This can be written as 3 raised to power 1 by 4, 1 by 3. Right? Second number is 4 is the third of 4, which can be written as 4 raised to power 1 upon 4. So here we take the LCM of this 3 and this 4 is 12. Right? So we write now, this can be written as 3 raised to power 4 inside the bracket. Outside the bracket we write 3 into 4. So this becomes 3 raised to power 4. It means 3 3s are 9, 9 9s are 81. 81 whole raised to power 1 by 12. Similarly, second case, we have to make this 4 equal to 12. Mean to say we are multiplying with 3. So this becomes 4 raised to power 3 whole raised to power 1 upon 4 into 3. So this becomes 4 into 4, 16, and 16 into 4, 64. 64 whole raised to power 1 upon 12. Now exponent is same, 1 upon 12, 1 upon 12. But inside, this is 81 and this is 64. What do you think, which number is greater? Because 81 is greater than 64. So this implies, what is the original form? This is 3 is the third of 3 is greater than 4 is the third of 4. So this way we have solved our question. Question number 10. Find 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4. Here we are going to discuss the shortcut method. Okay, in the very beginning, what is the first number? This is 3. So how many rational numbers are required to be find out between 3 and 4? Second number is 4. 6. So what we do? We write 3 into 6 plus 1 because of this 6. Divide 6 plus 1. So this way, answer is 3 into 7 upon 7. We can write this as 7 into 3, 21 upon 7. Here also we do the same thing. We write 4 into 6 plus 1, divide 6 plus 1. That becomes 4 into 7 upon 7. That is equal to 4 into 7 is 28 upon 7. Now this is very easy to find the 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4. Therefore we write 3 mean 21 upon 7. After 21 this becomes 22 upon 7. Thereafter we have 23 upon 7. Thereafter we have 24 upon 7. Next we have 25 upon 7. Next we have 26 upon 7. Next is 27 upon 7. Next is 28 upon 7, which is 4 itself. So how many numbers we have got? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 rational numbers we have obtained between 3 and 4, the shortcut method. Question number 11 is also very much same question. Find 6 rational numbers between 5 by 7 and 6 by 7. So in the very beginning, what is the first number? This is 5 upon 7. Now what we do? We write 5 by 7 into how many rational numbers are to be got? 6. So we write here into 6 plus 1 in the numerator, in the denominator also 6 plus 1. So this becomes 5 upon 7 into 7 upon 7. Mean to say 7 into 5, 35 upon 7 into 7, 49. Right? Second number is 6 upon 7. So again we do the same thing. 6 upon 7 into 6 plus 1 divide same 6 plus 1, which becomes 6 upon 7 into 7 upon 7. Mean to say 6 into 7, 42 upon 49. Now we start to solve the question. What is the very first number? This is 5 upon 7. And what is the last number? This is 6 upon 7. Right? So we write in between 6 rational numbers, the very first rational number, after 35, this comes 36 upon 49. Next comes 37 upon 49. Next is 38 upon 49. Next one is 39 upon 49. Next one is 40 upon 49. Next is 41 upon 49. So let us count them now. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 rational numbers we have got between 5 upon 7 and 6 upon 7. Question number 12. Write 4 is to 1 upon 8 in decimal form and find what kind of decimal expansion it has. So what is the number? 4 is to 1 upon 8. We can write this as 4 into 8 plus 1 divide 8, which becomes 4 into 8, 32 plus 1 divide 8. This is equal to 33 upon 8. Right? Now we divide 33 by 8. Long division. 33 divide 8. 8 into 4, 32. Right, 1 is left. 1 is smaller than 8, so we put here decimal. Simultaneously, we write here 0. So, table of 8 up to 10. 8 ones are 8. Subtracting 8 from 10, this becomes 2. Next, we take 0 by default. Right? So, table of 8 up to 20. 8 twos are 16. Right? Subtracting 20 out of 20, 16 subtracted, we got 4. 0 is by default. 8 into 5, 40. Now, 0 is the remainder. Mean to say, this is the decimal expansion equal to 4.125. Terminating after 5, there is no decimal, only zeros are there. So, this is the terminating decimal expansion. Terminating decimal expansion. Right? What is the meaning of this? This is rational number. Right? Rational number. Similarly, we have the next question, question number 13. Write 3 upon 13 in decimal form and find what kind of decimal expansion it has. Again, this is proper, proper fraction. So, what we can say, 3 divide 13, because 13 is smaller than 3. So, we write here 0 point, then this becomes 0, right? Table of 13 up to 30, 13 twos are 30, 26, 4 is the remainder, we take 0 by default, 13 into 3, 39, 1 is the remainder, 1 is small, 0 by default, okay, so this is smaller, so we take here 0, again here we put 0, 100, the table of 13 up to 100, this is 13 sevens are 91, so what is the remainder, 9 is the remainder, 0 by default, 13 into 6 is 78, right? So, subtracting, this is 2, 1, 100, 0 is by default. Now, what we write? 13 nines are 117. So, 3 is the remainder, 0 by default. 13 twos are, so this is 13 twos are 26. Subtracting, we are left with 4. Again, 0. What we see? This has repeated now. 40 was here. Again, 40 is here. Right? So, what we can say? We can say 0 point and 0 point 2, 3, 0, 7, 6, 9. After this 9, 2 is same. So we put bar sign. It mean this is equal to 0.230769. Again the same digits will repeat. That is 2, 3, 0, 7, 6, 9. Again same 2. Okay. So finally this is the non-terminating but recurring decimal expansion. So, we write non-terminating but recurring decimal expansion. What was the question? What kind of decimal expansion it has? So, it is non-terminating but recurring. Recurring mean repeating. These digits are repeating again and again. we put dot dot dot, right? Recurring decimal expansion. Now coming to next question. Our next question is question number 14. Express 0.357 bar upon 7, this is bar, in the form of P upon Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. So here, how to solve this question? We take X as the given number, that is 0.357 bar. So again we can write this number as X is equal to 0.35777 dot 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 dot, right? Now multiplying both sides by 100, so this becomes 100 X is equal to 35.777 dot 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 dot. Again multiplying with 1000, the given X, so this becomes 1000 X is equal to 357 dot decimal 7.777 dot dot dot. Now say this is number 1 and say this is number 2, right? Subtracting. Next step is subtracting. So we have left hand side is 1000x minus left hand side is 100x. Right hand side in 2. Number 2 we have right hand side equal to 357.777 dot dot dot, so on. Minus right hand side of number 1 is 35.777 dot dot dot. So this way we calculate this now. 1000 minus 100 is 900x, and this result is 000. 7 minus 5 2, 5 minus 3 2, 322. So 900x is equal to 322. So again this we can convert into X is equal to 322 divide 900, right? Dividing by 2 both sides, numerator and denominator, 161 divide 450. So this is P upon Q. P is 161, Q is 450. Both are integers and denominator Q is not equal to 0. Next question. Question number 15. Express 2.015 bar over 15, this is bar, in the form of P upon Q, where P and Q are integers and Q is not equal to 0. So what to do here? Let X is the given number equal to 2.015 over 15, we have the bar sign, right? So this we can write X is equal to 2.015 15 15 and dot dot dot, so on. Multiplying both sides by 10, we have 10x is equal to, this will become 20.151515 dot dot dot, so on, right? Again we can write this as 10x is equal to 20 plus 0.151515 and so on, right? Next time what we do, this we write as 10x plus 20 plus this second term is y. So this is number 1 and this is number 2. We suppose here like this. Mean to say, what is y? Here y is equal to 0.151515 and so on. This is number 2. Now what we do? We multiply both sides by 100. So this becomes 100y is equal to 15.151515, so on. Right? Now subtracting these two terms, that is 100y minus y, right hand side we subtract it, this becomes 15. Mean to say, we have 99y is equal to 15, which we can write as y is equal to 15 upon 99. Right? Further, dividing both numerator and denominator by 3, 5 into 3, 15, 33. So, now what happens? Question number, this was here, 10x. We have 10x is equal plus, 10x is equal to 20 plus y. What is y? This is 5 upon 33. Now taking LCM as 33, so this becomes 10x plus is equal to, multiplying 20 into 33, 660 plus 5 divide 33. That means 10x is equal to 665 divide 33. So x is equal to 665 divide 10 into 330. That is, cancelling this, 133 divide 66. So this is the value of x. Now coming to original question, what is x? This is 133 upon, this was the question. Express this number in the form of P upon Q. P is 133, Q is 66, where Q is not equal to 0. Our next question is question number 16. Locate square root of 3 on the number line. For this purpose, first of all, we draw one number line. Suppose this is the number line. Right? In the middle, we mark any point. This point is known as origin, 0. And we put arrow mark to the number line, both sides. Right? We take one unit distance. Suppose here I am taking 3 units equal to 1 unit. Right? So this is equal to 1 unit distance. So here I am going to make 190 degree angle. With the help of scale, I can construct this. With the help of scale, this way. Exact 90 degree angle is there. So again, I take the same equal distance, that is 3 units distance. Now what we did here, this angle is 90 degree angle. So this was 1 unit distance. This distance is also equal to 1 unit distance. Suppose this point is A point, and here we mark this point as B point.
right? Now what we do, we join this line O and B. O and B is joined here. So this way triangle OAB is a right angled triangle. So what is OB? This is OB hypotenuse square is equal to base square plus perpendicular square, one whole square. This means 1 square means 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. So OB becomes square root of 2. Right? Now making this OB as the base, OB is made equal to base. So this way I am going to put here on the OB. I am again going to make the 90 degree angle from B. Right? See here, I have joined the edge O to B. Now, again I am taking the 1 unit equal to 3 units distance this way. This is also a distance of 1 unit. And this point is named as C point. Now what we do? We join O and C. O and C are joined together. Now what we see? Second time, triangle OBC. Triangle OBC. Here at B we have the 90 degree angle. So we can say base square. What is OC? OC is equal to square root of OB whole square plus BC whole square. That means square root of, what is OB? Whole square, square root of 2, its whole square, plus BC is 1, 1 whole square. So that means square root of 3. This OC is equal to square root of 3. Now we take the help of the compass from here. This way I have. From here up to C, I opened the compass. Right? Now we make an arc. So this way we have the one arc. On the number line, the place where it has touched this point is D point, and this point is called square root of 3 on the number line. So this way D is the required number. Locate square root of 3 on the number line. Since this D point is the irrational number which can be located like this on the number line. Next question, question number 17. Locate square root of 10 on the number line. This is also the same question. Again we take the help of the number line, this scale. We draw one line. This is line, right? So here at any place we take zero mark. Both sides the line we have the arrow mark. So we take 1 unit distance, same equal distance, 3 units are considered to be equal to 1 unit. Here I am extending line up to here. So equal to 3 unit distance, equal to 1 unit distance I am taking. This is 1 unit, 3 into 3, 6, 2 unit, 3 into 3, 9. Okay. So this is 1, 2, 3, because 3 whole square is 9, 9 plus 1, From 3 we have the perpendicular this way. We have the perpendicular line. We again take the 1 unit distance equal to 3 unit in the perpendicular direction. So this way, suppose the name of this point is A and this point is B point. This is also equal to 1 unit distance. So we have OB. What is OB? OB is the hypotenuse. OB is the hypotenuse of the right angled triangle. The name of the right angled triangle is OAB. Right? So what we say? OB is equal to, hypotenuse is equal to OA whole square plus AB whole square. Square root of, what is OA? This is 3 whole square plus AB is 1 whole square. 3 threes are 9 plus 1, that is equal to square root of 10. So this irrational number is obtained here. So from making O as the center, we again draw the arc. From O to B, we open the, like this, we draw the arc. So the place where this meet on the axis, this point is C point, and this C point on the number line itself is square root of 10, the irrational number which is represented on the number line. Question number 18. Rationalize the denominator of 2 plus square root 3 divide 2 minus square root 3. So how to rationalize this? We take the given number 2 plus square root 3 divide 2 minus square root 3. We multiply with changed sign in the denominator. 2 minus, this becomes 2 plus square root 3 divide 2 plus square root 3. That means in the numerator we have a plus b into a plus b. So what is the meaning of a plus b into a plus b? It's square, which is equal to a square plus b square plus 2ab. In the denominator we have a minus b into a plus b. Right? That means a square minus b square. So what is a? A is 2. What is b? B is square root 3. Again, what is a square? This is 4. And what is b square? This is 3, square root 3 whole square. So here we write in the numerator we have a square plus b square. That is 4 plus b square is 3 plus 2ab. 2 into a is 2, b is square root 3. In the denominator we have a minus b into a plus b. That is a square minus b square. That is 4 minus 3, right? So this becomes 4 plus 3 is 7 plus 2 into 2 is 4. 4 into square root of 3 divide 4 minus 3 is 1. So finally we have the answer equal to 7 plus 4 into square root of 3 is the required answer. Question number 19. If A is equal to 3 plus 2 square root 2, then find the value of a square plus 1 upon a square. So here what we do? First of all, what is 1 upon a? That is equal to 1 upon 3 plus 2 square root of 2. So this can be written as into rationalization 3 minus 2 square root of 2. We change the sign, plus is converted into minus, upon same number 3 minus 2 square root of 2. So this becomes 3 minus 2 square root of 2 divide a plus b a minus b multiplied. So we have a square minus 2 square root of 2 its whole square, which is equal to 3 minus 2 square root of 2 divide 9 minus 2 into 2 4, 4 into 2 8. Therefore we say 1 upon a is equal to 3 minus 2 square root of 2,
right? So now what we do, we
say here a plus 1 upon a its whole square is equal to a square plus b square 1 upon a square plus 2ab, 2 into a into 1 upon a.
So 2 is left only. So this means
we can write this
equal to,
the value of a is 3 plus 2 square root of 2, right, plus 1 upon a value is 3 minus 2 square root of 2. Outside the bracket whole square, this is equal to a square plus 1 upon a square plus 2,
right?
So this becomes 3 plus 3 is 6, 2 square root 2 plus and minus cancelled. 6 whole square is equal to a square plus 1 upon a square plus 2,
right? So this way
6 into 6 is 36.
We can say
a square plus 1 upon a square is equal to 36 minus 2, that is equal to 34.
So this is the required value of a square plus 1 upon a square. Our next question is question number 20. If a is equal to 3 plus 2 square root 2, then find the value of a power 3 plus 1 upon a power 3. So in question number 19, we have seen that the value of 1 upon a is 3 minus 2 square root 2, right? Now we use the identity a plus b whole raised to power 3, which is equal to a power 3 plus b raised to power 3 plus 3ab into a plus b, right? So we take here the value of b equal to 1 upon a. So we write here
a plus 1 upon a whole raised to power 3 is equal to a raised to power 3 plus 1 upon a power 3 plus 3 into a is a and b is 1 upon a into a plus b, a plus 1 upon a. So this way what we means to say, what is a
here? A is
3 plus 2 square root of 2 plus, what is 1 upon a? This is 3 minus 2 square root of 2. Right hand side, its whole power 3. Right hand side is a power 3 plus 1 upon a raised to power 3 plus a in the numerator denominator cancelled. So we are left with 3 into a plus 1 upon a, that is 3 plus 2 square root of 2 plus 3 minus 2 square root of 2 inside the bracket.
Right? Now next
we have, this can be written as 2 square root 2 cancelled, 3 plus 3 6, 6 whole raised to power 3 at the left hand side. Right hand side we have a power 3 plus 1 upon a power 3 plus 3 into, this was left with 6, right? So
what we can say
finally, a power 3 plus 1 upon a power 3 is equal to 6, 6 is 36, 36 into 6 is equal to 216 minus 6 into 3 is 18. And finally, this answer is 198. That's all. Thank you very much.